Well, hello, my paranormal peeps, and welcome back to another Deep Woods Paranormal Podcast. My name is Matt Harvey. I am the founder and lead investigator with Deep Woods Paranormal. My wife and I, along with others, investigate everything paranormal in nature. Every week, we will discuss everything from creepy haunted locations to ghosts to Bigfoot, UFOs, Dogman, and other cryptid creatures, and explore all things paranormal in nature. Well, hello, my paranormal peeps, and welcome back to another Deep Woods Paranormal Podcast. My name is Matt Harvey. I am the host of the Deep Woods Paranormal Podcast. We basically discuss anything paranormal on this channel. And whether you're listening audibly or video-wise, all the links to our audio, video, our YouTube, our Rumble channel, everything's down below. It's all listed down below. If you want to contact us and be on the show, please feel free to email me or text me or even call me. If I don't pick up for some reason, please leave a message and I'll get back to you guys. Anyways, so getting into this show, I'm trying to get to the point. Bear with me. I'm a little under the weather. I had pretty bad asthma attack on Tuesday, and so I'm just struggling to get back to normal, so to speak. I do believe it might have been paranormally related. I do think I came under a demonic attack. And again, like I talked about last week, haunted objects, sometimes they're not always good haunted objects. I know it's a little blurry, but there are haunted objects on the shelf behind me. Of course, we got the haunted doll, and we've got this guy over here, which you can't see, the Raggedy Andy doll. Let me move this over here like this. So if you can see him over in the corner, over on the left here, one of these days I'll bring him over here. He has been absolutely creepy as heck lately, with eyeballs showing out of his eyes and, you know, him looking around and stuff like that. And the dogs have been reacting to him, all of the dogs, not just one, not just Zeus, not just Shorty, who normally sees the kids that are attached to the dolls behind me wandering around the house. But all of them have been reacting to that doll for some reason. So is it malevolent? I don't think so. Is it demonic in nature? I don't think so. I think this entity is just very active right now, which is cool, but it's also creepy as hell. I thought I saw the damn doll move the other day and stuff like that. So like my message to you guys, bear with me, is just to tell you, be careful when you pick an item up, especially if you're sensitive and you know something is attached to it. You better make sure that that item is, you know what you're getting when you pick up that item. When I picked up that doll, I could feel an energy to it, and I knew there was some kind of entity attached to it, but that entity and that energy seemed to have changed. I don't know if something else has possessed that doll or what, but just a little creepy. The rest of the dolls, besides this one here, she watches you as you're doing whatever. Let me go back in. Let me share my screen with you guys, and I'll put the camera back up. Let me share this. This is the video cameras. What you're seeing is actually live video of the antique store that we've been actively investigating. The cameras are a little behind for some reason, but you can see the different cameras we have in there. We have a DVR system set up. We're going to probably try and set up some more cameras in the antique store and maybe leave them for another week or two to continue to try and gain evidence. This case here is a little different. Speaking of haunted objects, you don't have possibly a haunted location, or you might. There might be an entity or two that haunt this location, but these items have come in from everywhere, possibly not just from Texas, from other places. And so it's a different type of haunt. You have multiple possible entities that are attached to multiple items, and it just creates different types of activity. You might have residual energy attached to something. You might have an intelligent haunt. There are reports of little kids attached to something in there. And the crazy thing is, as things go out and things come in, you get new activity. So, we're looking forward to getting back into this place. Also, it was a morgue at one point. The back section of the building was a morgue, and it's been a few other things over time. But we're looking forward to finishing out our investigation there this weekend, or maybe next weekend too, depending on our schedule. But we're going to be going back in there and exploring this place and trying to figure out what items may have attachments. And we'll share that with you guys on our YouTube channel here. If you're listening to the audio podcast, you're welcome to come on to our YouTube channel and take a listen and watch this podcast if you want. Again, the link's down below. Let's get into, I didn't want to really look at the antique store. I actually wanted to look at our office. Okay, so you see Raggedy Andy here. He the other day kind of tilted closer to this pillow and was like looking out the doorway at me because I was sitting on the couch. And that's when the dogs went absolutely berserk, and then he pulled back this way. Oh my goodness. Like I said, be careful what you pick up because there's just so many things that can happen with these items. But yeah, so haunted objects are fun. It's fun to have, but they're also kind of creepy at the same time. So if, like I said, if you're looking to pick up haunted objects, just be careful because you just don't know what you're getting with those things. Even if you're sensitive or medium or even psychic or whatever you want to call yourself, you just got to be careful. If something doesn't feel right, you probably shouldn't pick it up or bring it home. Now we have mainly dolls up here, and of course the Raggedy Andy doll. And we have other items that we, you know, at the time I didn't realize, wasn't thinking about it. People gave me things like this old razor up here on the shelf. And what else is over there? I picked up the dragon statue. Those things seem to have some kind of energy to them. And they're all positive. So, you know, I have an old preacher's wardrobe too, and that had in it and an entity attached to it for a while, and unfortunately, I guess he moved on. He decided he wasn't interested in staying with us any longer. So, anyways, like I said, I just want to give this warning to you guys because the more I've had haunted objects in this room, the more strange experiences I've had. This room is blessed. Nothing's allowed to leave this room. That's Mama Dog, and so nothing's allowed to leave this room or supposed to leave this room. But yeah, so now Mr. Raggedy Andy is about to get sat on by Mama Dog. But anyways, so yeah, just be careful what you pick up. Again, I just want to go back over that because we've had so many strange experiences with them. Let me stop sharing my screen. Like I said, if you guys are interested in learning more about the antique store that we're back after, excuse me, I can't talk today. Actively investigating. Stay tuned. We will have our first possible show coming out with that soon. I know I keep saying that the Exploring Unknown with Matt and Amanda is going to come out soon, but we've had some setbacks with that and had to make some changes and stuff. So let me stop sharing my screen. All right. So I don't know how long this is going to go today. We're almost at 10 minutes. Okay. So we've had more reports of paranormal activity and of, well, I should say cryptid activity along the Brazos River. I want to thank everyone who listened to the last podcast and responded. And then also email, we got some emails and some text messages saying we should check out here, check out there. Some of the places we've already seen. Let me share with you what I'm kind of talking about. This is our Google Maps. This has a lot of pins on it for possible Bigfoot sightings. These little blue dots with a little white spot in the center. So we've been getting a lot more reports of on the outskirts of town here of Bryan College Station of old reports. Now I'm getting them all the way up to where is this? What town is this? Hearn. We're getting them all the way up into Calvert and beyond. Waco, there's some reports out in Waco now. I've gotten a few reports from Waco. Where is this? That's a cemetery. I don't know what. Oh, there's a Bigfoot sighting in a cemetery, which is for some strange reason and happening more and more often. Tabor. What these don't. That's Waco. These are just coordinates. What is this? Mumford. That's out by my work. There's been reports of Bigfoots out by oil derricks. Snook, believe it or not, has had some reports of Dogman and also Bigfoot reports. Out by my work, actually, I've had some reports of not only Bigfoots but Dogman sightings. And then over by Lake Bryan, there's been some Dogman sightings. Also out by Hearn, also Dogman sightings. I don't know. And now I've gotten some more reports down here in Lake Somerville. These two pins, there's more. There's actually been more sightings down in Lake Somerville, and that makes sense. It's a very wooded area. A lot of deer, a lot of food down there. I've talked about Lake Somerville before, but yeah, we've been getting a lot of reports of Bigfoots lately, and also some people have actually told me if they're coming forward with Dogman sightings in our area. So I'm starting to wonder if Bigfoots and Dogman are really kind of staying in this area. We've got up here, if you guys remember, there was the all the UFO sightings, and Amanda and I were coming up the sixth the other day from Navasota, and we saw a red light, just a red ball, and it kept moving across the sky and then disappearing and then reappearing in a new place and moving across the sky and disappearing. It was weird, and then it finally disappeared and we never saw it again. But I've seen strange things like that out here towards the Brazos River too. Driving to work and driving home from work at late at night. If you don't know, I drive for a living. I'm not a trucker, but I anymore, but I do transport people around all over Texas, and I've been seeing a lot of strange things in the sky for some reason recently. Unfortunately, I've not had another possible Bigfoot sighting. Road crossing sighting, but I have had quite a bit of weird things in the sky. I'm not going to say they're UFOs or alien in nature, but I can't explain what they are. I just don't know what they are. Unfortunately, it seems to happen every time I'm driving and stuff like that. Let's talk a little bit about the city of Navasota, because this is a place that we're kind of starting to actively investigate. I'm not going to talk about what we're investigating down here, but it seems like since they started renovating a lot of these places and upgrading the city, there's been more and more paranormal activity down here, and we're starting to get more and more reports. Bear with me for a second. Sorry about that. I got a drink of some water here. Anyways. But yeah, oh, also, we've got some newer sightings down along the Colorado River in Bastrop. So, I mean, if you start to look along where the Brazos area is, you can just see a huge cluster of sightings of different things. Some of these are UFO, some of them are. Ghostly sightings, some of them are Bigfoot and some of them are Dogman. I'm sure we're missing some things in there. I'm sure there's probably some kind of river monsters that people aren't recording. I've heard stories of this one woman the other day told me to stay out of away from the riverbanks. She said there's something in the water that will come up and grab you. Now, out here, I think we have alligators and crocodiles in this area. I've seen them actually, believe it or not, in the river. We've got alligator gar, which can get really good size. They can get 6+ feet long. And then we've got other kind of critters. We have almost everything, basically that are out in the forest. So, anyways, we've had a lot of reports of strange things. And then you've got the cemeteries where they're getting Bigfoot sightings, where the Bigfoots are coming in and walking through the cemeteries. I still haven't been able to figure out why that is. Now, I've always said that every location I've ever been to that has consistent, I'm going to say consistent Bigfoot sightings, where I've been able to go, like, not just for a couple days or a couple weeks or a couple months, where I frequented quite a bit. Basically, I'm going to stop sharing my screen for a second. I've had ghostly sightings too. I mean, look back at Black Star Canyon, all the research, the years and years and years. And I started up there with ghost hunting up there. Then we had a possible UFO sighting, and then we encountered Bigfoots. And then we started encountering Bigfoots all the time. And it wasn't just me, it was a lot of people. So it seems like paranormal hotspots, it's starting to seem like ghosts, Bigfoot, Dogman, UFOs, and other things all seem to be like in the same area. And the more I do the research and the more I drop pins, I'm like, wait a minute. So you got a Bigfoot here, you got a Dogman here, you got a UFO sighting here, you've got a ghost hunting, a haunting here. And if you notice that a lot of the places where Bigfoot's, the canyons where Bigfoot seem to hang out, are also said to be haunted. And then people see strange UFOs and stuff like that, and whatever else. So I'm just starting to wonder if all this paranormal activity is like linked. If there's some kind of maybe, I don't know if, I don't know if I believe that Bigfoots can go through portals. I mean, I've heard a lot of researchers say that are into UFOs that we are the invaders of Earth. We came here and the Bigfoots were already here. I mean, that's just it's just a theory. So remember, guys, everything I talk about, you got to take with a grain of salt. This is all just theory until I can prove it to you. And at this point, it's just an interesting talking point. But I just want to make sure I say that so people aren't like, well, where the hell are you going with this? So, I mean, the more I do the research, the more I'm starting to consistently see UFO, Bigfoot, Dogman, ghost, possible, lake monster, river monster, and other cryptids and other unknown beings, in these areas. You're seeing aliens in force. You're seeing all this stuff all in the same area. Why is that happening? I'm asking you guys, comment down below. Let me know what your thoughts are. This channel's basically based off my experiences. And somebody was asking me the other day, how do you know that? Well, it's just based off my experiences. I'm not going to tell you. I've always said to everybody, I don't expect anybody to believe until you have had your own experience where you can say it could be anything else, but then you can put anything in there with ghosts, UFO, Bigfoot, alien, whatever, Dogman. So the more I have these experiences, the more I start to document these experiences, the more I start to put two and two together, I'm starting to go, what in the world is going on? Why is this one, these, why are, there's like locations everywhere. If you look at like Brazos Valley, why is there so many sightings? I mean, so many things happening in the same area. Why are there so many reports of ghosts? Why are there so many reports of UFOs? Why are there so many reports of Bigfoot and Dogman? And this is going back 200 plus years, back into the 1800s when, I think Brian was founded in 18 something, 1802 or something like that. I'm probably wrong. If the, I used to do the ghost tour in downtown Bryan, but I know the railroad came in around the 1800s, because that's when Bryan became it just like the population quadrupled or whatever, and then continued to grow from there on out. But yeah, I mean, the railroads have really brought a lot of people into these areas, which were before they weren't really touched. I mean, if you look at this area, we're still pretty forested, but the surrounding areas, if you could go back and you could go into like the Houston area, let's just use that example, because there are a lot of reports of paranormal things in Houston. There's UFOs, there's ghosts. You got a lot of haunted locations in Houston. You've got Bigfoot sightings. I don't know if there's Dogman sightings, but I'm sure there's other reports of cryptids and other types of paranormal entities that basically either haven't been reported or look back at the door. I'll have to watch back for that. Something looked like it just peered in. But anyways, I mean, there's just a lot of reports, and those areas all used to be very forested, and they didn't used to be so populated. These areas, as they grow out, have become more and more populated, and people are having more and more encounters now. Bryan College Station, over 200 years, we've grown out now, and they're building like crazy out. You look at Waco, you look at I know around the Dallas area, on the east side of Dallas, there's a ton of Bigfoot reports out there. And I'm guessing if you look into that, there's also probably a bunch of haunted locations out there. I need to do more research into that. But as I go, I'm learning there's more and more locations that have more and more paranormal activity. I mean, Fort Worth. Fort Worth has Dogman. It has Bigfoots, it has hauntings, and it has what is it called? UFO reports. So all these major cities where used to be forest are now more they're just paranormal. There's more and more paranormal activity. I think as we encroach in on Bigfoots and Dogman, and where UFOs used to be and stuff like that, we're kind of getting into the point where we're pushing them out, and they're not really leaving. It's kind of like when a new community opens up and they kind of push into an area that's forested and stuff like that, and all of a sudden they have a population with brown bears or black bears or grizzly bears. Well, you just moved into their home. And you just push them out, but yet they don't leave because that was where they maybe were born or whatever. So you're kind of getting my drift, hopefully. But we're gonna make this one kind of a short one, guys. I'm a little short of breath and still getting over this last bit of bronchitis. So, anyways, we're gonna go actually see Beetlejuice tonight and we'll have to give you guys a review on that and let you know how it was. But if you've seen it, please comment down below. Let us know what you thought of it. And then we'll maybe we can start up a conversation on that. One of the things I'm thinking about doing is doing a comparison on movies like Poltergeist, Ghostbusters, and like Beetlejuice. And looking at the movies and looking at real life, like real hauntings, and seeing where they really got it right and where they really went way off into the left field, and seeing what we can kind of say, okay, this is far-fetched, but it'd be pretty interesting to look at what they got right and stuff like that. So, anyways, we'll do like a movie comparison tier on one of these podcasts one of these days if you guys think that'd be fun. If you have a movie that you'd like me to kind of break down, or you want to come on and talk about a movie and what you thought was real and what you thought wasn't so real, comment down below. Send us an email, send me an email. Sorry, send me a text message or give me a call. Let me know what your thoughts are. You can remain anonymous, no big deal. We get a lot of anonymous emails where people just don't want to be known. And stuff like that. So, all right, guys. Like I said, I gotta get off here. I've got other things to do. But you guys stay haunted, and we will catch you on the next one.